Welcome to this second session where we'll be focusing on the process of peer review. Before going into the session, I would just use the polling option in AVIEW to administer two survey questions. So this survey question is related to the process of peer review in IIT Bombay X. So in, as you all know, in RCA 01 and RCA 02 of FDP 101X, we had used the process of peer review. Now, this is a very particularly in courses like this where there are huge number of participants, peer review is a pedagogical tool to ensure that there is learning and assessment happening together. And we have received a lot of email queries which informed us that there were problem in understanding the question, there was problem of improper peer review, etc. So I am first going to pose a question to all remote centers now. Within your remote centers, check how many participants in your RC had faced navigation issue in RCA 01 and 02. So by navigation issue, what I mean is they were unable to understand how peer review is done within IIT Bombay X. So where to go, what to write, etc. The remote center coordinators, just take a good quick survey within your remote center. Check how many participants had faced this issue. So there are four options. The first is more than 50%. Second is between 25% and 50%. Third is less than 10%. And fourth is 10% to 20%. So if you look into your AVIEW screen right now, you will see a poll that has come. And the poll, the question is, how many participants in your RC had faced navigation issues in RCA 01 and RCA 02? So take a quick count and answer the poll. The poll is visible in your AVIEW screen. So remote center coordinators are requested to take a quick raise of hands, and then so the poll will be open for around 1 minute more. So you will have to give an answer within another 1 minute. So I see that around 50 remote centers have given responses. So I'll be now displaying the poll results. So around 108 remote centers have answered till now. Around 60 of them have responded that less than 10% participants faced issues in navigation, but there are also a few. So around 22 RCs who say that there are 20% to 25% of participants in their remote center faced issues, and there are around 9 RCs where more than 50% of the participants had faced this issue. Yeah, so a larger percentage, we see that around less than 10% of participants in around 70-80 RCs had this issue. I'll just do one more refresh. So 139 remote centers have answered, and within 139 remote centers, so you will not be able to see the poll results, but it is visible over here right now. It says that around 80 RCs, there are around 80 RCs where less than 10% of participants had faced this issue, and there are around 29 RCs where the problem was between 10% to 25%. Another 14 of them, we see that the problem was there for between 25 and more than 50% for 14 RCs. So what this survey gives us information is that there are navigation related issues within IIT Bombay X peer assessment process. Now let me administer the second poll. The second poll is regarding whether you received peer reviews which were not expected, or let's say an improper peer review. So remote center coordinators will put up the poll right now. The question for poll is, how many participants in your RC had faced issue of improper peer review. We have started the polling. The options are first option less than 5%, second option 5 to 10%, third option 10 to 20%, fourth option 20 to 30%, and final option more than 30%. So if you look into your AVU screen, the poll has come up. This poll is available for 1.5 minutes. You can start answering the poll. How many participants in your RC had faced issue of improper peer review? Once again, around 80 RCs have polled. So around half, 50% of them, they are saying that less than 5% faced issues. But there is also around 10 RCs where they say that more than 30% of the RC participants had faced issues of improper peer review. So around 137 RCs have responded. So I will just read out the results. So around 56 RCs, they have responded that less than 5% of participants faced issue of improper peer review. Then there are also 36 RCs where 5 to 10% of the participants had faced this issue. There are another 21 RCs where 10 to 20% had faced this issue. 20 to 30% of people had faced the issues. And there are 12 RCs where this issue was more than 30%. So, first thing that we did with the survey is getting a quick feedback about both the navigation and review process that was conducted in RCA 01 and 02. This is because the upcoming session is closely connected to first the navigation aspect of peer review interface in IIT Bombay X, and also about the actual activity of peer review. In this particular workshop, there will be lot of resource creation assignments, particularly the open educational resource creation, which is very important, and where we will look at peer review mechanism for finding out the best resource created by the participants. And it is important that as participants, all of you are familiar with the process, the what, how of the process, as well as you also understand why we are doing this peer review and why is it important that you give accurate peer reviews. So I will now transfer the session to Dr. Samir Sahasrabude, who is joining us from RC1228 to further elaborate about the peer review process in IIT Bombay X.
Hello and welcome to this second part of the morning session. I hope everybody is back to their seats, and thanks to Jay Krishnan, who has beautifully managed to bring all of you to the topic. This is an example of contextualizing your lecture also. So for example, the next lecture is about the peer reviews and how to conduct peer reviews, the pedagogy of peer reviews. If that is the topic of the session, which was already announced in the in the schedule, what he has done is that the polls which were done as an activity, while people were settling down, some people were having the cup of their tea, also carrying inside and all that. During that time, he has managed to capture your attention to the topic which is supposed to be delivered next. And that is, I think, one good takeaway for all of us of how you can place the activity and what should be the content of that activity, so that our session or the lecture or the content, whatever we are going to deliver next, has a good base to start on with. So this is a very interesting thing, and I wanted all of you to note this. Therefore, I am making a deliberate mention about this. Okay, so coming to the topic which we are going to focus on, and it's Jayakrishnan has mentioned already that we are going to look at two aspects of it. One is because the navigation of IIT Bombay X is pretty new for many people. They have not tried this type of navigation. So we have seen that there are issues about it. And frankly speaking, we are also experimenting with it because the audience is diverse. We have teachers from all parts of country, of all disciplines. And because we have such a huge number, we are getting very rich feedback about every aspect of conducting this course, not only about the conduct of the course, but also for the website developers, like, okay, we want this button here and we don't want this color here. And this kind of things are also very important. And that is precisely the point of the navigation issue. One point you can definitely look at is, and I would like to share my screen now. So can you just share the desktop now? This is the website of LICET where I'm sitting right now, a beautiful place. And really overwhelming. I can't show you the other side, but it's a hall full of people who have gathered here to attend this session. And what thing they have done is that apart from the participants who are something like 50, right? 35. They have called others who may be interested in knowing about it. So maybe they are our future participants, or I don't know, some of them are past participants of the course. So this is a very nice thing to do. And what I want other remote centers to take away from this is that irrespective of whether people are enrolled or not, since this is happening in your college and you have invested in projecting it on screen and having a big room open for all this, maybe it's a good idea to ask people and sit down and have a look at what is happening in this. Good lectures like what Professor Sridhar or Professor Sana is going to speak in the afternoon could be a good point of knowledge for many others who are not doing the course, but yes, they can benefit from it. Okay, I digress, but this is the web site for the FDP2, which has started on 14th. And I am sure you can see some difference in the look and feel now. And can you actually spot some difference now? I want you guys to put it up on chat, and I'll ask locally here if there is a striking difference that you can see between the website of FDP1 and FDP2. So maybe locally you can answer me because I can hear you. People on chat, so this is how the page looked like for FDP1. This is how it looks like for FDP2. So can you look at and tell me what's one of the differences? We can just give the mic, or we will look at the chat if it has started already. We have some chat here. Yes. Okay. Colorful captions. Is this the answer of this, RC? Colorful caption. You want to change it? Add to it. This is look is better. It's Sau Sushila Dhanchan Godavat Kolhapur saying that the look is better. Yeah, people here also agree that it look is better. Can you be more specific?
Header image. Welcome to week one.
Welcome
the
to week
image.
One. Yeah, yes. But it is written there also.
The image.
Go to this thing. You'll see welcome to week one here.
No, the image which is included, sir.
The image.
Yeah.
What's so different about that image?
The feel what we get.
What learning. What is that feel?
learning.
Huh? So it's like from black and white movies we hired color movies. So yeah. Is that the only difference that we have colors now? What's the point?
The format is different.
The format is different. Okay. It is more focused, more catchy. Color combination of the caption. More focused environment, mentor-mentee interactions are not included in the tab. Okay, they're going slightly haywire also. Content is structured. Okay. So hold on. what I wanted to focus has come in some parts. But yeah, there was a feedback from a lot of people in our earlier courses also that the course looks very dry because it's all text everywhere and there is no break for your eyes and you have to keep reading all the time.
The aesthetic part is good. The aesthetics, the design.
Aesthetics, yes. So the aesthetics is something which will add to the experience of the user. So if you have different aesthetics, then the user will feel, will get different experiences. Better the aesthetics, better the experience is what is proven. But it is also proven that unwanted aesthetics will take away user from whatever they have to learn. So that is the catch. And we are trying to have that tightrope walk from now onwards because we never had any images and now we are introducing images. The challenge in front of us is that whether we will overdo it or we'll do it in a certain limit so that it is eye-catching. Also, it means that we will have to be sure about how people will access it. So we are trying to fix that. So having the session of how to access is a part of that scheme that we introduce the entire navigation through a lecture so that people will also take notes about it and when they do it on their own, probably they will do it better. And that is one way of trying to plug what was given in the poll that so many RCs found that navigation was difficult. So let us see after this session when they do peer review next time. It reduces to negligible number or not, and that depends on how I deliver this lecture. Anyway, so let us start by going to the screen where we have this week one and we have the graded activities. Now, before jumping into this activity screen, I wanted to just touch base on one important thing. You all agree that we have a massive number here. So it's a class of 5,000 students, right? And it's practically impossible to grade assignments physically by any number of instructors we put in. And even if we are so many instructors, but still it is not practical that we check each and every submission. And that too, when it is subjective. So if it is objective, then we have computers to do the thing for us. But when it is subjective, like write a list of learning objectives, then how will you do that? In that case, this technique of peer evaluation or peer assessment is a huge bonus and it can be used very nicely. However, in our past experiences, we found what you actually just gave the poll that some RCs found that 30% of the peer review was not done properly is the case which has actually reduced, and I would like to note it here. Last time this number was almost 50% of participants felt that the peer review was not done properly. That was one reason that I introduced this topic in my last session also in the FDP 1, and I am happy that things have worked better this time, that only a couple of RCs have complained that the peer review was not up to the mark. It actually points fingers to all of us at times, and please take this sentence with a pinch of salt. It is the interpretation which is actually creating the problem. So I see a sentence like I showed you an image and people interpreted it in different ways. Some people say it's adding aesthetics, some people say it is break from the text based thing, some people said it is more catchy. And there could be some people will say it is too loud. I don't want anything there. It should be like a book, which is only black and white and nothing else. Then I'll feel that it is academic content and I'll read it more seriously. Adding images and all makes it comics, and I don't want to read comics in academic structure. So there can be views, and views is what actually makes that peer assessment at the same time challenging as well as interesting. Challenging because if by unfortunate incident, you get three people who tell you that adding images is taking away my attention, then you will get 0 marks in your assignment. On the other hand, if you find all three people in tune with adding the image to enhance the aesthetics and look and feel of the image or the screen, then you will get 100 on 100. And if you get mixed bag, then you will be placed somewhere in between. So this depends exactly on how people associate with this. Therefore, what we have done is to provide you with a rubric. A rubric is something which is nearer to the overall percentage of things, and we have given you some markers to identify if you want help on what is the score of this particular submission. Then you have to go through that rubric and place the appropriate thing there. Now this also requires your own subjective reasoning, that if it is written that, so we will go through that, but then that is reduced to minimum, because if the rubric is written well, then you will not have such kind of problems. So that was our motivation in doing this. So let us go and see what happens here. One important thing which definitely happens here is that you are actually in a double role now. So a lot of moviegoers, and they constantly keep telling me, why do you give examples of movies all the time? But I can't help it. Being a filmmaker myself, I constantly go to that. So I was talking double roles. Double role here is that on one hand, you are submitting an assignment, right? So you are a student at that time. On the other hand, you are evaluating other assignments. So you are a teacher at that time, or you are an instructor at that time. So you have to toggle between. Now, it has happened n number of times, and I have met people telling me this, that whenever I am looking at other submission, I get ideas about how I should have written it or how I shouldn't have written it, because I can see the gaps or the pluses there. This actually is learning, because whatever you write at that particular timeline, if the exam was between 10 to 1, and whatever you wrote in that is what you could think about it at that point in time. So that's just a mechanism of assessment. But what is learning? Learning is where you know various aspects of doing the same thing. And if you see, we have chosen questions so carefully that it will have multiple correct answers. So there is not one correct answer. If it was, then we could have just done an auto grading of that. Because it has multiple correct answers, this particular methodology gives a scope of getting all those possible correct answers at one point. You can at least see three of them, and there could be all correct answers, or there could be a mixed bag, like I said earlier. But this aspect has to be thought at a slightly bird's eye view level. So you have to go back and assess the procedure also at times. You have to remember that, okay, if I can read this answer and then I compare that with my answer, then I realize, okay, maybe my reviewer is going to cut my marks on this because I have not done that. So that realization is so nice, because without actually receiving your review, you already know how much marks you are going to get. It may happen that they will not coincide with what you actually get. And that's where that more than 30% people were not happy with it, while area will come up. But that is what we are trying to fix. And one way of doing that is to understand the navigation, as well as increasing the level of interpreting the rubric to the highest possible level. So these two mechanisms will help you in getting a step forward, which is what we are trying to do with this session. Okay, so let us go to the resource creation assignment one. I like this graphic very much. My team has made it, so I don't have to really say it. What we are going to do here is that in not more than 250 words, explain how the use of ICT brings the changes in your own classrooms. Now, all of us now are aware of what ICT interventions can be used in the classrooms. You may have tried one or more, doesn't matter. What we want to know is that what were the changes which have happened in your classroom, and that has to be captured in 250 words. Now, if that is the idea, the chances are that people may go haywire and keep writing something which is not. I may write an essay on something which is completely not related to what others want to read. So in order to do that, what we have done is we have given a criteria, and we have also given examples of how you can actually create your example to suit that. So for example, criteria is evidence of usage. Check whether the answer has some evidence of usage of ICT in his or her own classroom. And the second is reflection of usage. So when the ICT is used, what has happened? So these two has to be definitely mentioned in that answer. That is, everybody will agree with that, right? But within giving that answer, there could be levels of different people trying different things. So we have given the range also here. So the first is no evidence has been provided in the answer, or there are one or two pieces of evidence and the answer contains three or more evidence. So this rubric levels are on the occurrence of the particular ICT or the examples used by the teacher. So if the occurrence is 0 or 1 or 2 and 3, you can say that, okay, I have used A, B, C, D in my classroom. Obviously, you know that it has been to be given at exemplary level because he or she has used more than 3 things in this particular thing. Similarly, how is the reflection captured? So I used a WordPress site or I used Moodle based something in the class is not good enough. Has it resulted in something? I have to capture that. And it should not be at a level that, okay, it was very nice. So it was very nice is absolutely no, it is in this category. The answer does not describe any reflection about the actual use of ICT. But if the teacher has tried to reflect the use of ICT and fewer details are provided, for example, how tools like PowerPoint and Moodle are integrated in the classroom, but fails to provide information like what worked, what did not work. So if that results are not shared, it is of no use to the third person who is trying to do that. So suppose there is somebody in the audience right now who is not participating and they hear from you this word called Moodle. So I use Moodle in my class or I use PowerPoint animation in my class. And they will ask, okay, then what happened? You will say it was great. Children loved it. But what is that loved it? Because if you have no evidence of what actually was the result, it is going to have no impact on the listener. So the teacher has to provide rich details about the usage of ICT, his or her observations on why this worked, why it didn't work. For example, if I have to write such a case, I'll say that I had used animation, 3D animation in my class where I was teaching subject on thermodynamics and the particular machine structure was not visible by naked eyes. So we had a cross section done in animation and we showed internal structure of how the vapors were going and everything else. That was interesting and that is what students have reported. So if I write this much, then it makes sense that you have understood how it has worked and you have given an example. Now people who are listening will take away that example and say that, okay, so in cases where the students cannot see a particular machine from inside. So I'm talking about a furnace, for example, mechanical engineering people will relate to it. The furnace at 2000 degree centigrade, where the molten mass will disintegrate into multiple things. Now I cannot show that by putting even a camera inside, because it will melt first of all. Now how do I do that? But animation is possible of that. Now if I use animation there and then report that students now realized that how it happens without, because they cannot see it inside, was reported by some students. If that is the comment I write, then probably the message is gone through and they know what is to be done for that. So we will also have one more checkpoint, whether student feedback, like that's what I was writing, saying just now, that students reported that, okay, now we can think of options which we could not otherwise see in the, so the textbook was giving two images of what happened before and after, but they didn't know what happened in between. And that is shown in that animation. So such kind of things, if there are present, then that is a good answer. If it is absent, then that is not a very good example, right? Now let us start doing this activity from the website itself. I hope I tried it earlier. Now I am a fresh student now. Okay. So in 250 words, explain how ICT is bringing in changes within your teaching and learning. So let me gather some examples from people locally, and I would like to ask others also to participate. So any intervention you tried in the class, unanimously you can come up to something. What is that? Any intervention? Yeah, quick. We have to be quick. Other remote centers, just wait, because I am going to ask you something. Okay.
Actually, I've used different types of ICT related.
Which one ICT you can comment on?
I've used Moodle.
Moodle, okay. So we are here, right?
Yeah.
So evidence of usage has some evidence of usage. Okay. So Moodle is used. Okay. Now, and any other thing?
Yeah.
Within PPTs, Moodle, within Moodle, what was
within
the...
Moodle? I've used quizzes.
Okay.
I've used videos.
Okay,
video sharing.
Right.
Then PPTs, documents,
assessment,
sharing.
Yeah. Uploading.
Yeah, assessment.
And assessment.
Okay. Yeah.
But, so we say we have used Moodle.
Yeah.
And we have used four features of Moodle, for example. Mm-hmm. I don't want to name them right now. That's okay. Now, the second question is to remote centers, where I'm sure there are a lot of people who have used Moodle. Animated flowchart, people are saying. Good. Valchan College, Solapur. Thank you. So somebody used animated flowchart, but I am sure a lot of people use Moodle anyway. So let us go by the Moodle theory first of all. If you have used any features of Moodle, what were the visible effects on the students' participation because you used these features of Moodle? So please write a sentence about what was the effect of a particular usage of Moodle feature on the students. So take a minute and write that. Okay, I hope you all can see this. What was the effect on of this selected feature in the Moodle on the students? Okay, so write one sentence about it. For you can write the feature and the effect, so that both things should come in that one sentence. I'm using Google Classroom, digital classroom, students interested in only MCQ is what Ratnagiri is saying. Elimination of duplicate vertex is what Dharwad is saying. Okay. In the quiz, immediate marks were seen as well as correct answers could be seen after the quiz. Okay. Is this a Moodle feature?
Yes.
Okay. I'm sorry. I'm kind of illiterate in Moodle. These students were able to see results immediately. Yes. So video sharing helps students accessing the content. Okay. So look at this sentence formation now. You have the reason and you have the effect, both in the same thing. Now, I want you guys to slightly modify your suggestions by quantifying it. So did this happen to all the students? Did it happen to some students? Did it happen to negligible number of students? Just try to be more specific. So say most of them, many of them, few of them, some of them, whatever. Let's see if we can sound better. Okay. Somebody is saying assignment submission is easy. That's slightly vague. So assignment submission on Moodle is easy, right? Easy is a slightly vague answer because it will not give you what is the difficult part in that. And okay, you can just attach it and send it also, but you actually have some other reason in your mind, but the way it has been framed is becoming vague. So maybe you can think over it and write a better sentence. Okay, so I have some interesting things coming up. Yes, we can quantify saying that 67% have scored or through Moodle conducted flipped classroom and collected student reflections. Quiz can be conducted easily using Moodle. Okay. 90% of took them the quiz. Okay. So this is participation level. So North Goa says that 90% of people took the quiz, which itself is an achievement because otherwise they were not taking it very seriously. But because it was on Moodle and they knew that online assessment is happening and their marks will not get things, so 90% people attempted it, right? Collecting course exit survey and its analytics is convenient in Moodle. Okay. Convenient. Okay. So, why? What was the cumbersome way of doing it? Getting a hard copy circulated or emailing people, or what was the other way? Without Moodle, how will you get the survey.
Google Forms is also.
You have Google Forms, okay. Yeah. So why Google Forms are not very good?
It is fine actually.
They are also good, yes. Right? Okay. Using discussion forum, students can do, okay, active learning strategy. Somebody from Aurangabad, it is so fast that I can't read it. Active learning strategy, implementation and effective discussion forum. Students can see justification. Okay. So I think we are coming there. Let me go back to the website now, because that is where we have to see the next stage. So I'm not going to actually copy any one of them, but just look at the guidelines given, and now compare your sentences with these guidelines and you'll get the answer yourself. You provide clear examples of how you have used ICT in your teaching learning. Okay. So you started a feedback form on Moodle is the feature what you are saying. You started it at the end of the course, middle of the course, you conducted various levels of forms is what you can elaborate on. Writing has your reflection on the changes that you have observed. Now that is where that quantification could have helped, that many students are participating as compared to less people participating earlier is a reflection on what changes have occurred, or they are faster in reflecting. They are earlier they were not responding maybe months together. Now we can put a deadline, we can have a timed affair, we can track them. So this has helped me in getting something. And the third is, you provide minimum of one instance of student reaction or student feedback in the use of ICT. That is actually the evidence part of it. So how you can actually convey it to people that, okay, because one student has told me this, I am very confident in telling this. So such kind of thing is also required. And then that will make it to 50 words. Right. So be elaborate. So right now I am only going to say 250 words, and I am just going ahead because I am not going to spend time on that. You guys have answered already enough, but yes, let us go ahead because we have to check the second part of it. This one was mainly to know how to submit a response and how to think to come to that level. It is your response part, right? So what you have to write. And the second part is how to assess other responses. Now, I think enough has been spoken about how you have to write your response and everybody has understood. I will just go to the chat once because there are many people who were trying to write something. Okay, there are too many things already. Google Classroom is a good start. I use ICT. In Moodle quiz, discussion forum is provided, but the evidence. Okay, feedback option, using pickers to check whether the students have understood the concept is not very effective. Okay, content sharing with learners is a half answer. Okay, I don't know what they have to say more than that. There is a question here. Let me see everything what is blinking. What is that? What actually have to with RCA 1? Oh, 10 a.m. It's an old question. I'll ignore that. Okay, I'll go ahead. In report and grades, we can find the students how many have attempted or not and what is the grade. So we can actually, reports help us in checking ourselves. So there are many things, but as I am trying to tell you, if it does not have these three points, then it is very likely that you will not be getting very good review. So please ensure all these three things are present. Actually treat it just like you are prompted to make a password of a website. If you make something, they'll say, oh, not strong enough. Then they'll say, okay, add a capital letter. Okay, then add an alphabet or add a special letter. Also. Similarly, we are giving you instructions. Okay, have the name clearly mentioned, have the evidence clearly thing written, and have some anecdotal evidence of some student telling you something. If three things are included, most likely you are through with it. Okay. Now, are you through also with assessing others? Because if you are not good at that, we will give you marks on that also. If you have not done the assessment properly for others, we are going to tell you that. Now, how do we do that? Okay. So this is the submission example. And now is the time for you to reflect. So everybody look at the monitors. I find like I'm running a KBC here, but so look at the monitors. Example solution submission number one. ICT provides lot of flexibility. I'll just increase the font size. Is it visible everywhere? I hope so now. I can't increase more than that. ICT provides a lot of flexibility in teaching learning. It is good to use ICT in the class as it will help students a great deal. Students are more interested in the use of ICT but have only a short attention span. This will cause problems, but still, if teachers use ICT well, then it is good for students. Now, remember the three pointers which we had mentioned, that it should have A, B, and C. Remembering that, let us try and grade the answer on whether it is poor, fair, or exemplary. I want the responses to be sent to me on chat. Reading this sentence and tell me whether this particular submission can be treated as poor, fair, or exemplary. RC coordinators can take a poll locally and give one answer from your RC, right? What we can do here also is the same thing. What is it? It's poor. Okay. I hate this site. Every RC is writing poor there. So for me, it is looking very bad that Valchand Institute of Technology Solapur poor. That is very bad. Okay. So bad joke. So they were very smart. They wrote 0 points instead of poor. Yeah. So let us see if we give it poor. Secondly, let us also see whether the answer provides rich reflection on teachers' usage of ICT in the classroom. Is there some reflection? Does not describe any reflection. It has tried to show some reflections and it has provided rich details. Now, out of the three, what would be the choice? Now, please mention in the answer, you can write two and poor or two and fair and two and exemplary, because I will get confused between the first question and the second question. So now make it, the answer should be two and then whatever answer you want to have. Let me see what's coming up. Two poor. Oh, it's like too bad. Too poor. Okay. Too fair. Okay. Somebody is saying fair for this. There are poor, more poor. Somebody is writing only two also. So fast in typing that they just enter. Okay. So lot of poors actually. What is that our RC says here locally? Is it fair? Has the teacher tried to reflect on use of ICT? However, there are fewer details provided in the answer. Are there few details, too many details, or no details? Louder. How many people feel few details? How many people feel no details? All others feel too many details. You have to have some answer. You can't say, you can't be on the banks of acha mai ye bhi nahi aur wo bhi nahi. So you have to give some answer. I think poor or more. Should I click on poor? Okay, let's go ahead. Okay, RCs, wait. Stop on the chat. Look at the third question. Now check whether there are quotes or instances of some student feedback in that answer. Absent, present? All present are saying absent. Okay. All present in front of me are saying absent. Okay. So let me see what RCs are also saying. Absent, absent, absent. Oh, people are saying three absent. Good. Okay. So we have absent all over the place. Great. So let us see. Here, when I press compare, I will be told whether I have assessed things properly or not. So this is actually not the writer's test. This is my test. And I'm doing on behalf of all of you. So if I fail, you all fail. Let me see. So this was cleared because the color was green. If we had clicked on fair by any chance in any one of them, then it would have been different. And I did a mistake of not doing it. Otherwise, you would have seen it. But I'll do that mistake now so that you see how the system will tell you if you are wrong. Let us do that now. I've been a most obedient student here. So that is why we are not getting exactly. Okay. So the part two of the question. ICT has proven, so this is the response. Now let us read the response. ICT has proven to be a great game changer for teachers like me. Now this sentence can be interpreted in any which way, and if only this sentence is present, then immediately you have to click on poor, right? But the person has written something more. Evidence of usage is I extensively use PowerPoint, PDF documents, interactive simulations and Facebook page. Not only the teacher has mentioned what has been used, but for what it has been applied is also mentioned here, which is important to note, right? So PowerPoint to present slides in the classroom and PDF documents to share resources, important points. Also note, PDF documents is to share information. They are not doc files because they can be tampered. So PDF is something you can only share with people. So some very critical points, but you have to remember that. Student feedback, student enjoy these resources and they are very excited. One student had explicitly written on Facebook post that the simulations helped me clarifying the concept that he learned. They are widely shared by his friend and other colleges. Reflection. Thus, I see ICT has increased the access and efficiency of the teacher learning process in the class. However, I find following drawbacks. And then the person has listed some of the, with use of social media, we have to be extra careful about data privacy. So somebody's assignment you have posted on Facebook without consent, that person may sue you for that and you have to face the music. But yeah, barring that, it is supposed to be very good. But this is important. Students seem to be more inclined to social media gratification. So teacher giving 5 on 5 is not very important. Having 5 likes on Facebook is more important. So that is how things are. And that teachers are understanding. That is why they have reflected here. So let us see, how much will you give the score to this submission? Is it poor, fair or exemplary? Exemplary, why? Because it is very long. So, okay, let me see what the remote centers are saying. Exemplary. I just modify my question. Why exemplary? I just modified my question, remote centers and loyal icon. Please, let us hear it on the microphone.
Sir, evidence is there as well as reflections also here. You mentioned the reflections also. Evidence, feedback from students and reflection, everything is there in that.
They have written reflections also.
Yes.
That is one reason why we should give exemplary. And?
Feedback, students' feedback.
Students' feedback also is given. And?
Evidence of using ICT. Evidence.
Right. So whatever was used also is explained. So these three criteria match. Therefore, we have to give exemplary is one definite answer. Right? All questions are covered. Yes. Exemplary because examples and evidence is there. Yes, all the requirements are fulfilled. Three evidences with reflections. Yes, so now look at it. The person answering, the remote centers answering, three evidences with reflections is said by Shirpur Dure. So now they are quantifying the quality of the answer. They are saying because there are not only one in evidence, there are three evidences of reflection, which is important, right? So if you can give 20 also, but then we have put a limit of 250 words. So remember that. Do that. Let us go, and this time I'm not going to listen to anybody and I'm making it poor. So this is how it happens. So somebody writes a beautiful answer and gets a poor tag on that. So what happens? Therefore, what we have new mechanism actually will tell you, if your answer is not matching with the actual rubric, then how it will show up. Let us see that. Okay. Determine whether the answer provides rich reflection on the teacher's usage of ICT. The first question was about some evidence of usage of ICT by the teacher in their own classroom. So evidence was already poor. That is what we are determining. And then whether the answer provides rich reflection, let us say it tried to reflect on the usage of ICT and see what happens. I have been like conjuice reviewer, so I will not give full marks to anybody. I'll say fair. Okay, and let's see what happens. And check whether there are any quotes, and I say they are present. Okay, let us see. Now, with these settings, and you all know what is the answer actually, but you know that Samir is a conjuice reviewer and he has done something hanky-panky here. So what will happen is that hanky-panky will no more be accepted because it will not turn green. It will show me an orange color, which means that your assessment differs from the instructor's assessment in the response. Therefore, review the response again and consider why the instructor may have assessed it differently. So you have to go back and read the answer once again and find out your own mistakes, what you have been doing there. Now this will enable the point of filtration which was happening on wrong reviews getting each other, and we are trying to see how many people falter in this stage itself. We are going to keep a record on how many people have done mistakes here, because then we can actually slot those as bad reviewers and keep them separately and not mix up with the entire crowd which are doing a religious review of things and not like conjuice reviewers like Sameer. So we will find out those people. Now selected options differ in this particular point is also specified here. So not only the entire review, it's a goal answer, then a person will also get confused what is missing in my thing. So selected option differ here. So okay, I think I'll be fair now. And even here, so I'll make it exemplary now because I realize, but this option is correct and that is reflected as green, so you can go ahead. Now let me see mera thoda conjuice cheez kam karne se kya hota hai. It is still not getting me because this is exemplarily written a piece of a review, a submission, and because I have been clicking on fair, it is not allowing me to go ahead. Similarly here, because I changed it to exemplary, it has allowed me to and made it green now. This was already green, and because I have changed it to exemplary, it will get me to the next level. I'll try to play more mischief and make it poor now and see what happens again. Still it will not allow me. So this is how the software has been built and the rubric has been built. Now there is no need to write down these options because this question is going to change. The examples are going to change, the rubric is going to change. So you will not have any chance to copy, by the way. So Jay Krishnan is making a strong note of these things, and we are going to come up with a new example with new text in that, so that you have to apply your mind once again and see for yourself. Okay, so now let me see compare. And yes, so learn to assess responses are done properly now, and you are at the complete stage. And when you actually complete these two stages, you will get a chance to assess the peers, and similarly the peers will get chance to assess your submissions, and that's how the system works. So unless and until you do it right, you are not going to go to the actual assessment. That is what one more filter we have added, and this is how this entire thing works. So I hope we are clear about how things are going up here. So let us take questions on this now, because we just finished the part which I wanted to share with you. So let us go to Gitanjali Institute and start interaction. Gitanjali Institute, please ask your question.
Actually, I have submitted RCA 2 in the first FDP program, sir.
Okay.
Some of the piece has reviewed my RCA 2, sir. They has given only 1 out of 8 points, sir.
Okay.
Then I communicated with my mentor Rajni madam, sir.
Okay.
Madam has once again paid my RCA 2 work, sir. She has given 6 out of 8 points, sir.
Okay. Are you happy now?
Then how to rectify the progress, sir?
Okay.
Actually, I have done all the work, sir. My mentor has given 6 out of 8 points, but the person who reviewed my RCA 2, they has given only 1 out of 8 points, sir.
Right. I got this now. So how to rectify? I'm sure Jay Krishnan is listening to this and making note of it. You are representing many such people who had the same problem. I think somebody here had the same issue. Yes, no, maybe.
Yes, sir. Rajni ma'am has already mailed to IIT Bombay also, sir, regarding this issue. We have given feedback also.
Would sympathize with us because there are 5,000 people mailing us continuously, and we have a different subject line for every 5,000 mails we get, and it's a huge task, by the way, to sort them out and actually see what's lying beneath, and this effort is one of them. So yeah, we take your feedback and we'll come back on this. If you have mailed, be rest assured that we will take some action on this point definitely.
Because of this score has reduced, sir.
Score, yes. Because of that, the yes, score sir. Has reduced. Is actually
of course, I have promoted to second FDP, sir. There is no problem regarding promotion. I have got a 75% score in the first FDP.
You could have got 80%. Or 78%.
Yes, sir. Yes. But I did the work, sir.
Yes.
I did the work. There is no result regarding that, sir.
Right, right. And also because we had selected some top performers in first FDP, people are now really having a competition here. That okay, but it is very good. Actually, I mention it with important things. I have some message coming up. Yes. So Jayakrishnan is waiting there to answer this kind of question. So let me see if there is anything else in the other questions, and then I'll pass on the mic to Jayakrishnan at IIT Bombay. Let me just go over sir. To Symbiosis and let me ask them the question. Oh, Symbiosis, go ahead if you have some other question about the peer activity what I explained just now.
Yeah, sir, there may be many people among us who may not be, knowing about ICT tools. Hello.
Yeah, yeah. I didn't get the first part of the question. Who may not be knowing the ICT tools, I could hear.
Yeah, there may be many participants who may not be knowing about the ICT tools. They may perceive that use of Moodle means ICT, application of ICT in the classroom. They may end up with the wrong peer review.
Right, right. Okay, so there could be a situation where the matching. And so if your review goes to somebody who doesn't know that Moodle is a valid ICT tool, then what happens? Is that the question?
Yes, sir, same question.
Yeah, this is precisely which can happen, and it has happened. And that's the reason actually we expect it not to happen frequently now. Because of two reasons. One is because this is FDP 2. So by this time, people will at least have, and if they are past FDP 1, probably they will be definitely knowing about what is this tool and which is not a tool and other things. Plus, we don't have just one reviewer assigned to you. So there will be three reviews. So if in case this thing happens with one of the reviewers, then there is a chance. But yeah, we will, so we have mechanism for that. That's how we can actually counterbalance it. Let us go to IRCM and see if they have any other question. And then I think I'll pass on to Jayakrishnan at, yeah.
Sir, my question is how to write or how to student feedback in RCA01.
Yeah. How to write?
Or how to feedback in RCA01.
Ah, okay. So how to enter it into, okay, fine. So
yes.
Over to JK, because Jayakrishnan, because he is going to speak about two points. One is the policy matters about what happens in case where you got lower marks because of bad reviews. And second, what happens with the entering of data, not able to log in and other stuff. So I am just going to stop interaction here and let us take the question here, and then I'll transfer the floor to IIT Bombay.
Yes, sir. In posting the response to RCA1, whether we have to provide any link or like that Moodle link or WordPress link in the particular response, or just we can type the sentences alone, that's sufficient.
Okay. So Jayakrishnan at IIT Bombay, you can take back the floor and answer all the questions which have been asked to you directly. A couple of things were related to the UI part, which I have tried to answer, and others which are pertaining to policy, you please take back the floor. So can you take back the floor from here?
Yeah, so thank you, Dr. Samir. There were two queries that came out from the remote centers regarding peer review. The first was regarding what is a mechanism to handle improper peer review. So in the cases where somebody has done very well, but the peer has not reviewed that person well. And the second one is how to provide answers or how to key in answers for RCA 01. So let me give you a standard policy that we'll be applying in this particular FDP. We understand that resource creation activities are crucial and are also instrumental in identifying top performers. So we will be thinking of, so as a policy, we will the course instructors will be taking a call on the peer review process, and we may incorporate a mechanism of penalty. So which means that if somebody has done a poor peer review, then that poor reviewer, it is visible to us, so that peer reviewer will the reviewer will have will introduce a thing known as penalty points, and if it crosses, let's say, a threshold of some, we'll decide a threshold. So there are three resource creation activities, and based on the grades that is there, overall grade, we will look at giving penalty point for each criteria. So how this is going to be implemented? We still be having the mentor mentee cohorts. So at any point, if the mentees feel that they have been given wrong reviews or incorrect reviews, then please bring them to the notice of the mentor. So mentor or the associate faculties who have taken this particular course in the previous offering will now review your submission, and based on that they will put up one score, mentor's review score. So the mentors will be consolidating all these scores and sending a peer review report to IIT Bombay. So we'll be having a mechanism to do this. So we'll be collecting this through a survey from the mentors, and based on the mentor's feedback, we'll be looking at cases where there has been an improper peer review, and we'll be looking at penalty points for the reviewer who has done this. Now there is also a case where the review is proper, but somebody has complained that the peer review is not correct. So here also the mentor's review of the scores, will be looking at, the mentor will be given specific instructions to look at the validity or the genuineness of the review, and based on that provide us the feedback. So we will be having penalty points for both improper review or even improper complaints. So these the mentor mentee interactions are even more crucial in this particular FDP, where there is more focus on resource creation activities. The entire open education resource, the flipped classroom activity creation, everything is having a crucial linkage to peer review process. So as a policy, we will be investigating mechanisms of introducing penalty points for poor review. Now regarding entering into RCA 01, so in this particular FDP, the first question is all about how you have used the three technologies that we discussed in FDP 101X in the previous month. So you can note down mechanisms through which you have done it, and for the student feedback, you need not write very long explanations. But suppose you had a survey, you have conducted a survey, and let's say the students provided feedback onto that, all you can do is you can write two lines saying that I had administered a survey, and based on which I got the following, in which, let's say, more than 60% of the students found it useful. So these kind of summary of the survey can be provided as one way in which the student feedback is there. Or if there is a very specific student feedback that you want to specifically note down, let's say somebody said, one of the students said, I got interested on seeing this particular Moodle, I went and explored and I created a Moodle server on my own. So these are expressions where students are showing interest and taking the ownership of use of technology on their own. So these kind of experiences can also be shared as answer. So you need not give, what you say, your WordPress link or other things. The first RCA is a descriptive explanation. So it is like an essay question. And we have said that not more than 250 words, because the reviewer has to read through everything and provide you the feedback. So be very crisp and ensure that you have looked at the review criteria and then provided the answer. So that is the way in which you should be going ahead. So please do not worry. I hope all of you have got the message. So all the associate faculty who are there, just like what you did in RCA 01 and 02 in the previous FDP, in this particular FDP, you can consolidate all the peer review grievances and share it with IIT Bombay course team, so that we will be understanding what the how the variances in peer review and take appropriate actions from our end. As course instructors, we will be discussing this in the subsequent days, and we will be putting up the policy decision on the course info page also. So we'll what we'll do now is we'll just break for lunch right now. Please do not worry. Once you come back, I'll repeat this policy once again, and then we'll move towards the next session where Professor Sahana Murthy would be discussing about moving from 20th century to 21st century teaching learning process. So we'll break for lunch right now. Thank you.